So, you're a healthcare provider, nurse, biller, or manager, and are used to the 5-digit ICD-9 codes. Heck, you got a bunch of those diagnosis codes memorized and can rattle them off the top of your head. Introducing ICD-10, with up to 7 alphanumeric characters. Let's take a closer look at how ICD-10 is formatted. ICD-10 starts out its codes with the first 3 characters identifying the category. The first character of the category is always a letter. The second and third characters can be numbers or letters. There is always a decimal after the third character, unless the code is made up of just 3 characters, which is the minimum number in the code set. The fourth character defines a subcategory and can be either numbers or letters and identifies the site, the cause of the disease or condition, the symptom, and or stage of the condition. The fifth and sixth character further define specificity, such as location and laterality. Big word, but it just means what side of the body, left or right, as in big left toe. Some categories have a seventh character extender, which can be a letter or a number and changes the entire meaning of the description. For example, the seventh character could stand for initial or subsequent encounter. Some codes need the seventh character, but don't need the fourth, fifth, or even sixth character. So, what do you do in those cases? How nice that ICD-10 thought of that. It uses an X as a placeholder. ICD-10 does this to be able to expand the code set in the future to be more specific. So, as we go from 3 characters to 4, 5, or more characters, the diagnosis becomes very precise, which is the whole point of ICD-10. Oh, and did I mention? Your documentation has to be even more detailed nowadays too. Nuts, huh?